News time! Hey everybody, welcome to Brick Vault. My name is Mike and welcome to the news episode. This week we have official images for the new architecture set, also a lot of minifigure stuff, book stuff, some movie stuff and game stuff. So let's get into it!
And of course be sure to check out the links below the video for some cool Amazon deals. And this week brings these awesome sets on sale, but there are still good deals going on from the last week, especially on the Star Wars line. And to start off the news this week, we have the official images for Arc de Triomphe set number 21036 from the architecture line. It was first unveiled at the Nuremberg Toy Fair, and now the official images are showing the set in detail. And this building will be joining the famous Paris landmarks, that is the Ville Savoy, Eiffel Tower and the Louvre. The details of the set include a single gold stud that will be in the middle to represent the eternal flame on the tomb of the unknown soldier. And we will be also seeing some microfigs in white form as the Ark statues. I have been to the real landmark in Paris, and I honestly can say that this set looks excellent. It will be available starting August 1st and will retail for around $40. Next up, we have some unveilings for the minifigs. The first one is with Marvel Super Heroes 2 game, and now we know that the deluxe edition of the game will include the Giant Man exclusive minifig. Along with the minifig, the pre-ordered deluxe edition will get you early access to the classic Guardians of the Galaxy character pack, which may include Yondu as seen in the promotional graphic of the game, and we can also probably see other characters such as Stakar Ogord, Martinex, Charlie27 and Aleta Ogord, just to name a few. We can also expect some DLCs in the future, and this edition will grant you a season pass to have all of them. And most likely the Giant Man minifig that we get with the game will be also a character in the game with some special abilities. As of this recording, the pre-order for this game is available at Best Buy for $75, and the game is scheduled to launch on November 14. The next minifig we are expecting to see soon is a polybag for the Ninjago movie that will contain Lloyd. This is polybag number 30608. And the leaflet for this one was unveiled on the LEGO's building instructions page. It is yet unknown how you will be able to obtain the polybag, if it's gonna be a standalone purchase or will come as an extra for the game perhaps. I mean the rumored LEGO Ninjago movie game that may be coming soon. And there also seems to be a code on the corner of the polybag that may unlock the character in the game. It looks similar like game polybags previously that were unlocking characters for LEGO Batman 3 Beyond Gotham, LEGO Marvel Avengers or LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. Good thing to know also is that LEGO Boost Creative Toolbox, set number 17101, is now available for pre-order at Shop at Home. This is the new introduction in the interactive LEGO Bricks line, and at 840 pieces it will retail for $160. This is a great way to get into LEGO Robotics, and you can of course expect a review from us or even a more comprehensive video on the LEGO Boost line as soon as we are able to do it. The LEGO Boost will be available starting August 1st. And now onto some rumors from Delta Customs. We can most likely expect some Avengers Infinity War sets along with the release of the movie, and that is pretty obvious because we are getting sets for every Marvel movie released. That seems like a bigger release of 4 sets, that is one more than Guardians of the Galaxy 2, which had 3 sets with the movie. Also the Jurassic World 2 movie is coming and we are also getting sets for that most likely. And there are also rumored brickheads for Justice League and Star Wars The Last Jedi. That will be the first time we are getting official brickheads for the Star Wars line. Well, this is a pretty fresh line of sets in LEGO definitely, so I'm not surprised that we are beginning Star Wars characters in this one. The Last Jedi movie release is also expected to have the Boba Fett buildable figure release. I'm really looking forward to this one. And coming back into the LEGO Batman movie franchise, the highly popular LEGO Batman BattlePod polybag will most likely finally be available in a wider release. Right now it is available at Legoland California from June 6th to June 30th. With a $20 purchase for annual pass holders, and it will also be available for general park guests starting June 13th with purchases of $50 or more. The polybag was also spotted in the East Coast Toys R Us stores, but it is not known if it is only locally released and if the polybag will be available online at all. I kind of want to get one because it holds an exclusive Batman minifig, and we are collecting all these minifigs pretty much. And as summer is kicking in, we are getting a lot of new information about LEGO based games. First one is that LEGO Next Nights is now available on LEGO Worlds game, and there are new things to do with this theme such as building the Nighton Keep and playing your favorite Next Nights heroes and their vehicles. With the running rumors that Next Nights line may be ending in LEGO in favor of Ninjago, I am happy to see them in the game and I'm actually do enjoy this theme. There is also a big event coming in the game world that you probably know of, the E3. It starts soon on June 13th, and for 3 days towards June 15th, Warner Brothers Interactive Entertainment will be showing off different LEGO games, including LEGO Worlds, LEGO Dimensions, and LEGO Marvel Super Heroes 2. Also, for the first time ever, the event will be live streamed by Warner Brothers, so we'll be able to see what's going on live on their website. Our very own Jack is scheduled to go to the event to cover those games, so you can expect first-hand look, especially with the LEGO Marvel Super Heroes 2 game, and information about all the new updates for LEGO Worlds and Dimensions. Stay tuned for a news feed about all this stuff from him somewhere around the event. And in more news, we have a lot of LEGO-based books coming. The first one that I really like is the book called LEGO Absolutely Everything You Need to Know. I expect this to be a nice publication from DK Books, and it will be a 240-page book filled with facts about various stuff about LEGO. You can now pre-order it over on Amazon, and it will be available on September 5th for $20. The book is so cool that we may even review it when we get it. There are also two books coming from the guys at Scholastic Klotz, the first one being the LEGO Make Your Own Movie, and the second being LEGO Ninjago How to Draw Ninja Villains and More. I am not very much into such books, but I'm pretty sure those are great options for younger LEGO fans, so if you want to get your children something else than LEGO sets, that is a pretty good option. And the last book I want to mention is called The Tips for Kids Transformers Cool Projects for Your LEGO Bricks. This new book is coming from Joachim Klang and Alexander Jones, aka Orion Pax, and the 208 pages of this one will be filled with tips and ideas on how to build Transformers out of LEGO. A lot of Transformers characters from the most likely G1 cartoon series are present on the book's cover, but we are not sure if all those builds will be included in the book. The book will be available starting July 10th. And you can also check Alex Jones' website on Flickr, we have mentioned this creator a number of times and he has some cool Transformers projects right there. And one more coming thing is the LEGO DC Super Hero Girls movie that is called The Brain Drain. Somewhat of a weird title if you ask me, but it is a product of collaboration between Warner Brothers Animation, DC Entertainment and the LEGO Group, and will be distributed by Warner Brothers Home Entertainment on July 25th, 2017 and on digital HD on August 8th. It should be about $20 movie, and if you are into DC superheroes girls, well, I am totally not, you may be interested in this one, but I will probably skip.
Alright, and let's jump into the LEGO Ideas section. If you don't know what LEGO Ideas is, that is a website where you submit your own LEGO creations and people vote for them. When you get 10,000 supporters, LEGO gets them into the review for manufacturing. This week did not bring any new sets approved, but I have two sets that I wanna showcase.
The first project on the Ideas website I wanna support today is called the UCS London Bus Route 38 by Great Mazinga. Well, it sounds like a bazinga to me, if you know what I mean, but the project is no joke. It is actually a really cool concept. It is of course a larger scale of the London Bus promotional set that we got in our hands some time ago, and I honestly think that this massive UCS scale gives that iconic vehicle the tribute it deserves. At 2656 pieces, it would be the biggest Ideas set to date, and I cannot say that this is not possible as the idea set because we just got the old fishing store approved with 2049 pieces. I think the project at current state has everything it needs to become an idea set. The beautiful looks, the amount of detail and the structural integrity are all there, and also this beautiful double decker is modular so you can take off the upper floor down and also remove the roof to unveil the seating. I think it's a great set and I would love to see this on the shelves, so if you can, go onto the LEGO Ideas website and support this project. The second project I want to support today is completely different. It is called the Medieval Market Street by OMS5134. I think this nice modular design is a great tribute to the classic castle LEGO theme, but it is definitely much more detailed than most of the sets from that line. The corner vignette has a part of the castle building, along with some merchant shops from the medieval ages, and a really good collection of minifigs included. I like this flower stand in the middle that adds up the colorfulness to the scene, and all the tiny details on the building's facades, along with all those rooftops and the tower raising above the market, are all just making a great little scene. Even the pavement looks great using a mix of tiles and single round pieces. But don't get misled, even though it looks tiny, it is a 32x32 base plate like every modular, and it consists of about 2300 parts, which is another over 2000 parts project for Ideas, but I'm really hoping that LEGO has just started picking up those big projects for manufacturing. So good luck with this one, and if you can, go and support it.
Alright, and that is it for this week's news episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. Leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed the content. And tomorrow is the Mox episode, so look forward to that. My name is Mike, and I'll see you again on Brick Vault. Click.
Thank you.